Let's take a look at the tail of the tape. Lucien Boutte and Edison Miranda. Boutte, 30 years of age, 6'2". Both fighters made the 168 pounds comfortably on our unofficial scales. Boutte rehydrated to 182 pounds. Edison Miranda to 185. Time to take a look at the rules for tonight's bout here in Montreal. No three knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight. Scorecards at the end of four rounds for an accidental clash of heads cannot be saved by the bell in any round. We'll hear from Howard Letterman through the course of the fight for his scoring of Boutte and Miranda. Well, we're getting ready for the introductions, and first to come into the ring will be the challenger, Edison Miranda. Miranda, 29 years of age, raised himself on the streets of Colombia. At the age of 14, got into street fights, ventured into a gym, and has worked his way to this point. 33-4, 29 knockouts. In his defining fights in his career, he has come up short, as Max illustrated. But he says, now I'm a different man, I'm a different fighter. He got 300 rounds of sparring in, working with his new trainer, Joe Goosen. Max, they say he's more polished, he's reacting in the gym better, but how does he deal with his swing change under pressure?
Yeah, you know, he has a ton of heart, Edison Miranda. Keeps fighting through adversity, we've seen it in his career. And as Lennox mentioned, he's a special kind of puncher. He might be, along with Randall Bailey, the best pure puncher in boxing. So maybe a little bit does go a long way, but Bob, it's gonna have to, otherwise Boutte outclasses him.
Well, he said it was God's will that led him to this point, and finally teaming up with Joe Goosen for him to take the next step in his career. We know about his devastating punching power. Can he add enough boxing skill tonight to deal with a very talented, undefeated fighter and a hometown favorite in Lucien Boutte? In a tune-up fight, Miranda in October knocked out Francisco Sierra. Well, Lucien Boutte, 25-0 with 20 knockouts in October of 2008 right here in Montreal. He was beating Lobato Andrade handily, but he started to run out of gas in the 12th and final round. Andrade knew he needed a knockout, and he landed a devastating right hand that put Boutte down. Referee Marlon Wright was in the middle of the controversy, though, with this extended count that lasted over 10 seconds. That bought Boutte enough time. He was able to make it to the final bell, as you see Wright cautioning Andrade, who did absolutely nothing wrong. The final bell rung, and Boutte came away with a very controversial victory, as he would win a unanimous decision in front of 16,000 fans here at the Bell Center to make his second title defense. Then two fights later in Quebec on HBO's Boxing After Dark in November, different story. Boutte felt his conditioning was much better. He was able to drop Andrade twice in the fourth round. The left hand to the body finished it. According to CompuBox, he landed 60% of his power shots. Now Lucien Boutte hopes to do it again tonight in Montreal. Lucien Bouté has made his way into the ring in front of almost 14,000 fans here at the Bell Center in Montreal. He'll defend his title tonight against Edison Miranda on HBO's World Championship Boxing. Now for the formal introductions to the ring and our ring announcer, Pierre Beignet.
Mesdames, Mesdames et Messieurs, bonsoir et bienvenue au Centre Bell. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Bell Center here in beautiful Montreal, Quebec, Canada, as Interbox, in association with Videotron and in collaboration with La Cage Spa, Coors Light, Goose and Tudor Promotions, Warriors Boxing, Le Casino de Montréal, and the Venco proudly present HBO's World Championship Boxing. This event is brought to you under the supervision of the Province of Quebec's Gaming, Racing, and Liquor Commission, represented this evening by its supervisor, the director, Mr. Michel Hamelin, and by the IBF with its supervisor at ringside from New Jersey, Mr. Darryl Peoples. Medical supervision supplied by Drs. Pierre Meunier and the Marc Gagné. Les juges vont se combattre, the judges for this championship fight. De Montréal, Mr. Jack Woodburn. From Philadelphia, Mr. George Hill. And from Montréal, Benoit Roussel. L'arbitre, the referee, Mr. Ernest Sharif. Mesdames, Mesdemoiselles, Messieurs, 12 on the box pour le championnat mondial du super moyen de l'IBF. Ladies and gentlemen, this is it. This is what you have been waiting for. And they're going to go toe-to-toe. 12 rounds of boxing for the IBF Super Middleweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, in the blue corner, il porte la culotte noire, orné de rouge, wearing black, trimmed with red. Il enregistre un poids de 167 livres. He weighed in at 167 pounds. S'affiche 33 victoires, seulement 4 défaites, et 29 de ces victoires sont par mise hors de combat. His professional record, 33 wins, only 4 defeats, with 29 wins coming by way of knockout. Fighting out of Carolina, Puerto Rico, now residing in Vinyls, California. Introducing the hard-hitting contender, Edison de Pantera Miranda. Son adversaire dans le coin rouge, his opponent in the red corner. Ce soir, il n'a besoin d'aucune introduction. Il porte la culotte rouge et argent. Wearing red, trimmed with silver. Son poids officiel, 167.2 livres. He weighed in at a solid 167.2 pounds. S'affiche, parfait! 25 victoires, aucune défaite. Les 20 de ces victoires sont par mise hors de combat. His professional record, absolutely perfect. 25 wins, no defeats, with 20 wins coming by way of knockout. Ce soir, il règne en tant que champion mondial. IBF introducing the current undefeated IBF Super Middleweight Champion of the World, the Montreal, Lucien Bouté.
Touch him up and go.
Boy, the first thing you notice is Boutte's height advantage, but he showed against Lebrado Andrade in his last fight, Boutte did, that he might be more than just a tremendous local attraction. He might be a special talent, and he better be, because he's facing a desperate puncher tonight. Emphasis on the word puncher.
One thing that Miranda has cut out of his game is the trash talk. He's been a lot quieter leading up to this fight. He said when we talked with him yesterday, I've grown up a little bit, want to talk more in the ring. My trainer is quiet, meaning his new trainer, Joe Goosen. I want to follow suit, feeling more comfortable in my own skin. Let my fist do the talking. Will that big right hand do the work? They're very confident in the Miranda camp, Lennox, that he is no longer just a one-handed, right-handed power puncher, that his left hand has become just as proficient. They've worked on all these little things. Now we'll see in the crucible of a championship fight in front of 14,000 fans on the road if he can execute the things that he's learned in the gym in the solitude of just he and his trainer.
Well, the good thing about it that he's had nine weeks of training, and you know, you have to be able to catch something from there. You know, he's come out in his first round with his left hand out. That's unusual for his style. So he's looking a bit different than I've seen him before. So
9 months of training.
There's nine months. So he's got to have some difference. You know, having a good trainer. I always said he's a great puncher, but he needs a great trainer. And somebody to spend some time with him. So let's see what has come out of that.
Joe Goosen, his new trainer, talking about Miranda, was at the Andre Ward loss last May in California. He was just watching the fight. And he said, as he was watching Miranda perform, he said, this guy is just a one-trick pony. But he realized after working with him in the gym that he's a tremendous athlete, an athlete in hiding. They think they've taken some of the veil off that athleticism with more skill. Boutte shoots a left hand right to the chest of Miranda. Miranda works his jab, takes a jab back from Boutte. Feeling out process here in round number one. Great talking with Lucien Boutte and his trainer Stéphane LaRouche yesterday. Boutte has been in Montreal now for the past 7 years, speaks French fluently. The fans and media love him here. Left hand by Boutte, then he throws a hook to the body. First meaningful connects so far here in the fight. Boutte has been having HBO dinners, they call them, every couple of weeks, where all they do is speak English so that he can handle himself in the fighter meetings. He did a pretty good job yesterday. Miranda to the body. Boutte slaps right back to the body, and a combination to punctuate the end of round number one, as Miranda did not hear the bell. And he went after Boutte. Well, we invite all of our great boxing fans to log on to HBO.com. You can track the punch zone stats live as they happen during the course of tonight's boxing, not only here in Montreal, but in Atlantic City. Break out the laptop and follow live punch zone stats at HBO.com.
Use a crisp jab, Lucien. Be sharp. Keep going at him. He's going to touch you. He might come in on the inside, but be aware of his strength. Crisp jabs.
So the bell begins round number two in the scheduled 12 rounder. Lucien Boutte in the red, putting his super middleweight crown on the line against Edison Miranda. Pretty good final minute and a half of round number one for Boutte, Lennox.
Yeah, Boutte was looking good. He was not getting hit. He was moving around, using some good footwork. I think it was just a feeling out round for both fighters. And, you know, different things are going to come in different rounds, but you could definitely see that Miranda is changing up his style a little bit. He's trying different things.
Boutte got a left hand through that peekaboo defense.
Miranda's always spoiling for a fight, as you mentioned, Bob. What happens when you're actually in there, and you see when he gets hit, he gets mad. He wants to fire right back. But he does seem to be approaching it with a little more technique than we've seen in the past.
And he's a little more calmer than we've seen him in the past, trying new things. You can tell he's thinking a little bit more than he usually does.
And Butte did tell us yesterday that his jab is going to be the key and that he still has to be cautious. And when the crowd starts getting into it, there's an exchange, he's got to remain focused. He says there is not a minute, there is not a second, Lennox, that you could take off during a round. He said against Andrade, you know, there were different lulls where I could relax a little bit. But against this guy, if I relax for just a second, this guy could knock you out.
And he has the power to knock you out. Sometimes Miranda's moving against the ropes and putting his hands up, inviting Boutte-ing. I don't know what he's doing that for. Maybe he's trying to counterpunch, but
like the heads came together there.
I thought that was a right hand by Miranda, actually. I thought it was a short right hand on the inside.
What Miranda needs to do, he's throwing that jab, he's just throwing that left hand out there, but he needs to take a step with that jab so he's a bit closer to Boutte, even with the right hand. But, you know, more jabs need to come from Edison Miranda right now.
Miranda clearly seems to have more of a plan in there than we've seen in the past.
And he's getting a couple of these punches home. Boutte, meanwhile, seems like he's doing as much stalking as moving. When he's playing defense sometimes, as we see right now, it's while he's coming forward.
Miranda picks off that jab from Boutte. Boutte touched Miranda. Miranda shoots a right hand. Tries to go to the body, and that's how we end round number two.
It's two rounds for you.
He's confused.
He doesn't know what to do with you.
Don't stay in the ropes too long, Lucien. You cannot stay in the ropes too long.
Remember, last 30 seconds.
When you put pressure on this guy, you got to escape afterwards. He doesn't know what to do if you pressure him, but don't stay in the ropes. Move around in that ring. You've got two hands. Use them both all the time. Go, Lucien.
So we begin round number three. You heard from Stefan LaRouche in the corner of Lucien Boutte and Edison Miranda. His corner, Joe Goosen. Goosen said, you got two rounds, Lennox. And Miranda, I'm not necessarily sure if that might be the case.
Well, you know, I don't think they need to count rounds. They just need to make sure that they win the fight. And I think that's the wrong thing to tell him. You should be telling him he's losing because of the fact that he's not in his hometown and he's boxing against a hometown fighter.
And he's losing.
That's what, you know, if Manny was in my corner, he would be telling me I would be losing.
You know what's interesting, though, guys? Oh,
good right hand by Miranda to start that exchange.
In the corner, it seemed as though Boutte's corner was a little more anxious. And with a puncher like Miranda, you understand why.
And Miranda just came through with a great right hand straight and hit Boutte. Boutte took it on the chin, didn't say nothing about it. But
combination from Boutte. Miranda says, that's all you got? He didn't trash talk leading up to the fight, but down he goes.
Oh.
With a short punch inside.
I guess he had some more.
Not unfamiliar territory for Miranda. He's been down, but can he gather?
That's it.
Ernie Sheree stopped it. That wobble back by Miranda was enough to convince him to stop the fight.
Lucien Boutte fought an aggressive fight.
He's offensively oriented, and he scored his second consecutive spectacular, essentially one-punch knockout.
I'm surprised by that. I know Edison Miranda's surprised by that. You know, at first he was saying he had no power, but all of a sudden some power came home, and he got hit and dropped and reacted from it, couldn't recover from it.
I've been a short uppercut inside, Lennox.
Wasn't expecting that punch. Obviously, there's more punches in Boutte's arsenal, and that's a punch we haven't seen before. We've seen the uppercut to the body, but we haven't seen the uppercut to the chin, and this fight brings out different things that Boutte has and punches. And here we're going to take another look at it.
Uppercut.
Miranda did not see that coming, didn't expect it, landed flush on the chin. I mean, he was fully surprised. He put his head down, figuring just to get away from a punch, but he put his head right into an uppercut.
You know, they love their hockey here in Montreal, and that punch went right through the five hole, right between the goalie's legs, right through Miranda's defense. Perfectly placed uppercut. And Lucien Boutte, impressive performance as he disposes of Edison Miranda with an uppercut in round number three. And the chance of Boutte by the nearly 14,000 fans here at the Bell Center ring out for their adopted favorite son.
I don't know. I think that moves into number one position.
Well, you know, Max talked about the comparison. You know, Andre Ward is considered the top guy in this weight class. Miranda went 12 rounds with him last May. Boutte finishes off Miranda in round number three. We take a look at the total punches. Not a heavy output from either fighter as far as the amount of punches thrown. Boutte landed 47 of 103. Miranda just 21 of 144 in the fight. Power punches in favor of Boutte as he landed a whopping 62%, 23 of 37. And it was the well-placed left uppercut after Miranda had feigned that he wasn't hurt. Well, he got hurt by that uppercut. He got dropped, and he got finished. Time for the official time of the stoppage once again to the ring and Pierre Bernier.
We're up to stop about 1 minute, 22 seconds of the third round. For the winner, Levanka, he's toujours still current, undefeated, IBF super middleweight champion of the world, Lucien Boutte.
Make it 26-0, 21 stoppages. Another impressive performance for Boutte. They came to see him dominate, and that he did against Edison Miranda with a perfectly placed left uppercut that finishes off Miranda. As Boutte makes the fifth defense successfully of his super middleweight belt tonight here in Montreal, Canada. A stirring night here in Montreal. The loved Habs lost in overtime to Washington tonight. That series even at one, but it ends on a happy note for the fans in Montreal as Lucien Boutte stops Edison Miranda in the third round. Let's send it to the ring and Max Kellerman.
Congratulations, Lucien, on another spectacular knockout victory. You came out stalking Miranda, who's a puncher. Why?
T'es sorti en force et tu le talonnais, lui qui est reconnu pour sa puissance. Pourquoi t'es sorti comme ça?
Parce que j'ai travaillé fort, j'ai exercé 12 mois en Floride, j'ai travaillé pour cette uppercut-là et ça marchait comme il faut. Depuis quand on a commencé à travailler en Floride, j'ai dit avec Stéphane, on va commencer fort, on va occuper le milieu de ring puis on va contrôler tous les combats. Ça va être facile.
It was simple. I worked hard for 2 months in Florida to do this, and we had agreed during the training with trainer Stefan that we would start off on a strong note and take control of the center of the ring. We worked the uppercut during training. We worked this out greatly tonight and executed the game plan to perfect.
So while we're used to seeing you box a lot, you now look like you're knocking guys out like a southpaw Tommy Hearns. Is this what we're supposed to see more of in the future?
On est habitué de te voir boxer davantage, mais là, tu sembles y prendre goût d'appliquer des KO un peu comme un Thomas Hearns gaucher. Est-ce que c'est ce qu'on doit attendre de toi à l'avenir?
Je vais travailler fort, je vais faire mon mieux pour gagner, pour rester invaincu. Puis je regarde beaucoup, beaucoup Tommy Hearn, beaucoup, beaucoup sur ses vidéos. Puis elle m'inspire beaucoup.
All he wants to do is keep working hard, keep winning, stay undefeated. He's been watching a lot of Thomas Hearn's video. He's inspired him a lot, and that's what he wants to keep on doing.
Well, you're fighting like you've been watching Hearn's. And right before the knockout, Miranda posed as though you hit him and you didn't hurt him. Did that redouble your resolve to knock him out?
Just avant le KO, Miranda a pris une pause. Et comme si tu ne l'avais pas atteint, si tu ne l'avais pas fait mal, est-ce que ça t'a inspiré de lui appliquer le KO par la suite?
Je l'ai touché solide 2 fois cette round-là. Puis il a fait semblant, comme il n'a rien, mais je l'ai senti. J'ai regardé dans ses yeux, puis je l'ai senti. Puis j'ai appliqué le uppercut.
I hit him hard twice in that round. He tried to make it as if he wasn't hurt, but I knew he was hurt. I could see it in his eyes, and I wanted to give him the knockout to get this thing over with.
There's a tournament going on now at 168 pounds. The leader of the pack at this moment looks like Andre Ward. Ward went the distance and beat Miranda. You just knocked Miranda out. Was that on your mind?
Il y a un tournoi présentement des meilleurs boxeurs de 168 livres. Le meneur, semble-t-il, dans ce moment-là, c'est Andre Ward. Ward est allé la distance avec Miranda, il a gagné le combat. Tu viens de passer le KO à Miranda, est-ce que tu pensais à ça pendant le combat?
Non, je n'ai pas pensé à ça. J'ai dit que depuis le début, je veux faire mon mieux pour gagner le combat. Puis j'ai fait la meilleure performance, puis ça va marcher, ça a marché exactement comme j'ai voulu.
He never thought of that. All he wanted to do from the start was to be at his best and win this fight for the fans, and that's what he did tonight.
Bernard Hopkins has recently called you out. What are your thoughts about fighting Bernard Hopkins as you wait for the winner of the tournament?
Bernard Hopkins t'a récemment invité à se battre. Quelles sont tes pensées? Quel est ton état d'esprit par rapport à Bernard Hopkins alors qu'on attend la fin du tournoi?
Je respecte beaucoup, beaucoup Bernard Hopkins. C'est un great champion. Puis après ce combat-là, on va s'asseoir avec mon promoteur dans la table pour parler, pour savoir exactement qu'est-ce qui va arriver. Je suis ouvert à n'importe qui. Je suis le meilleur super middleweight. Je suis prêt pour n'importe qui.
We'll sit down. First of all, I've got tremendous respect for Bernard Hopkins. He's a tremendous champion. But at this point, we'll sit down with our promoter and decide who we take on. I am ready for all the best. I am the best 168 fighter in the world.
Maybe. Congratulations, Lucien. Bob.
Well, in the third round, it was a perfectly placed left uppercut that put Edison Miranda down. He staggered around as the referee gave the count, and then the referee stepped in and stopped the fight in round number 3 as Lucien Boutte takes care of business. Lennox, you know, you take a look at Lucien Boutte, and all we see right now is a guy that keeps getting better and better. No airs about him. He shows up for fighter meetings with him and his trainer, Stéphane LaRouche, nobody else. He's a very well thought out young man, but he seems to be really growing and getting better each time out. When you look at his performance tonight and you couple that with what he did against Andrade in his last fight, have we even seen the best yet of Lucien Boutte?
Well, you know, I was really surprised at seeing the uppercut, because usually he throws the uppercut to the body, but he threw the uppercut to the head right now. And I think there's a lot of other punches in his arsenal that we haven't even seen yet. So he's improving each fight as he goes along.
Well, a very stirring night tonight here in Montreal, an electric atmosphere here at the Bell Center. And Lucien Boutte takes care of business as he finishes off Edison Miranda in the third round.